Kentucky Derby, the oldest continuously held sports event in America. It's the 127th Run for the Roses, and perhaps among the 17 entries is the horse the sport has been waiting for since the 70s, the decade which produced the last Triple Crown winners, Secretariat, Seattle Slough, and Affirm. The temperature is in the 80s, and the track is lightning fast. Hello, I'm Bob Costas from Churchill Downs in Louisville, Kentucky. On this first Saturday in May, it's the dateline for the most famous 2 minutes in American sports. 2 minutes of racing over a mile and a quarter in a setting as historic and evocative as golf in Augusta, baseball in the Bronx, football in South Bend. 2 minutes that the great novelist John Steinbeck, in attendance here some 40 years ago, called an emotion, a turbulence, an explosion. One of the most beautiful and satisfying things I have ever experienced. 2 minutes that will be viewed again today by some 150,000 here at Churchill Downs and millions more around the world. Welcome to the Kentucky Derby.
Begins here in a 12 by 12 stall. This is where the Run for the Roses really begins.
What is it about Kentucky? Why are most of the world's best thoroughbreds born here? Cherished dream?
I get them when they're babies. I train them. And one day, they become a legend.
A dream of capturing lightning in a bottle. On the first Saturday of May.
Showed up at Churchill Downs, and you look up and see the Twins fire. I'm so excited, like a little kid.
The Derby has been the ultimate ever since I can remember that I wanted to be a jockey.
I start the Kentucky Derby. How's that for a childhood dream come true?
Twins fires, history has been made for 126 consecutive years. And a horse race has become a celebration of America. Today, one dream will be realized with a garland of roses. Celebration of spring, that is Kentucky Derby Day. Billionaires Row is packed with big money players. While down in the grandstand, novices, racing fans alike lining up at the windows, all in search of a winner. For the ladies, hats are the winning look, the colors rivaling the brilliance of the jockey's silks. And down in the infield, the spring break-like party goes nonstop. The riders await the arrival of their equine partners and an appointment in the world's greatest race. All the pre-race hype swirling around Point Given as he tries to fulfill predictions of greatness. And Bob Baffert, his trainer, holds a powerful hand because he also trains the late developing colt Congaree. At 54, jockey Lafitte Penkai could become the second oldest to win the Derby. He'll be aboard Millennium Wind, a half-brother to Charismatic, who wore the roses in 99. And two former adversaries on the basketball court, Rick Pitino and Bobby Hurley, renew their rivalry on the track. It is a sun-baked day at Churchill Downs. The fans sweating in the sunshine. The temperature in the 80s. Here at race time, 84 degrees. The humidity, thankfully, is low. Partly cloudy skies. The track is fast. Underline fast, because already three track records have been set on the undercard today here at Churchill Downs. Welcome to Churchill Downs, everyone. I'm Tom Hammond. Happy to be here for Derby 127, which is unfolding in extraordinary fashion. We have a superstar that has a deep and talented field of 17, and we have a lot of wonderful stories to tell as well. The Derby, of course, is the first leg of the Visa Triple Crown. A $5 million bonus awaits the horse that can sweep the Derby, Preakness, and Belmont. And a chance to make some money today, too. There's a new law in Kentucky which says in million-dollar races, there will be no entries for common ownership and no mutual fields where several horses are coupled as one betting interest. So there are some boxcar figures on the tote board today. Let's take a look at the odds currently. Song and a Prayer on the Rail is a long shot. Millennium Wind and Balto Star, two of the few horses that are single digits on the odds board. These numbers correspond to post position since there are 17 interests. 7-1 on Congaree. Dollar Bill, maybe surprisingly, maybe it's because his jockey Pat Day, extremely popular here, is 5-1. As you see, the favorite is Point Given. He opened up at 9-5. He's gone up just a bit at 2-1. And happy to call in Charles C. Canty, who has been at the Derby for a number of years in a row, has been advising us all week on how we should cover it. And Charles C., I said this was a deep and talented Derby field. I really think that's the case.
There is no question that this is a very talented crop of three-year-olds. The speed figures have already proven that they're faster than the average group. Therefore, we've got a really contentious Kentucky Derby, one of the more contentious ones in years. And even if Bob Baffert had stayed home in California, even if we had no Point Given and no Congaree, we'd still have our hands full debating the merits of Millennium Wind and Monarchos and Balto Star, to say nothing of about a half a dozen long shots who could really jump up and run big.
Yeah, I think if Point Given should stub his toe, there are about 10 other ones that could win the race easily and not shock you. Well, Bob Neumeyer's with us, of course, and right now he's on the backstretch, gauging the mood there before the horses walk over for the Derby. What have you found out, Bob?
Well, Tom, I'll tell you, for the trainers and the owners and even the horses, it's really the calm before the storm. But for over the 150,000 people who are here at Churchill Downs, I want to share with you a little Derby tradition. This is the so-called gauntlet. This is the area that the horses will be walking in, in about 10 or 12 minutes from now. Between these fans and admirers, they will make a left-hand turn onto the racetrack and then make about a 10-minute walk to the back stretch. What's at stake here? Plenty. To the winning owner, $600,000, not to mention the infinite amounts of possible money and future breeding fees that are at stake. And Tom, we can remember last year, Fusaichi Pegasus, how his value skyrocketed after winning last year's Derby.
Yeah, skyrocketed like the space shuttle, Bob. If you'll remember, in the fall as we came to the Breeders' Cup, he had been syndicated for about $60 million. That is, as you say, what is at stake today. Well, you can also compete with our handicappers today if you can log on to msnbcsports.com. We have a special interactive feature that lets you handicap the race, plus take part in our online cybercapping by matching your pick against the picks of our analysts. All at msnbcsports.com, the official website of NBC Sports. Second largest crowd of all time on hand at Churchill Downs, over 154,000 for Derby 127. The 127th Kentucky Derby is brought to you by Visa, proud sponsor of the Visa Triple Crown. By Miller Lite. Grab a Miller Lite. It's Miller time. And by Chrysler, we're reinventing the passion for driving.
Some athletes don't care about endorsements. Some athletes don't care how many fans they have or what kind of shoes they wear. Some athletes don't even care if they're televised coast to coast. They just want to run. The Visa Triple Crown takes a lot of heart, but at the ticket booth, they don't take American Express. Visa, the official card of the Visa Triple Crown.
After a lifetime of working and saving, your assets can really add up. But without the right protection, you could lose a lot to estate taxes. At Prudential, we understand that growing and protecting wealth go hand in hand. With decades of experience in estate plan funding, we can help you reduce estate taxes that could run as high as 55%. That way, more of your estate ends up with the ones you love.
When you bring your first one home. Chrysler Voyager. Re-engineered and redesigned with dual sliding doors and over 45 standard safety and security features. It's the most affordable minivan you can buy. Now get a $2,000 cash allowance or 0.9% APR financing on Chrysler Voyager.
This is an NBCI surprise event update. On Wednesday during the hit show Ed.
Oh my gosh!
Judy Thompson was reunited with her son she gave up for adoption 33 years ago.
I can't believe it.
But it turned out Judy had one more surprise waiting for her.
This is Brianna.
Judy got to meet her beautiful granddaughter. You can see an all-new NBCI surprise event during Ed every Wednesday in May at 8, 7 Central, right here on NBC.
With a stunning comeback, the Miracle Mavericks knocked off the Jazz. Now they face the top team in the West, the Spurs. The NBA playoffs, next, immediately after the Derby.
Monday, 8, 7 Central, TV's hottest game gets even hotter.
Who's suffering from rolling mental blackouts?
Weakest Link, Monday at 8, 7 Central on NBC.
Welcome back to Churchill Downs in Louisville with the Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company sending their Ohio-based blimp, Spirit of Goodyear, to provide aerial views for today. Goodyear blimps appearing over sporting events since 1925 and providing aerial TV coverage since 1962. Well, trainer Bob Baffert has been the subject of all the media attention, and at his barn, he's had the Bob stress board all week. Well, this morning, as he relaxed on his car, he looked pretty much relaxed. The Derby has taken on a new dimension with Bob Baffert on the scene.
That can be misinterpreted for arrogant, or they say cocky. I have a tendency of joking a lot. And I sort of got a little hoof and mouth disease there. Once I started winning a lot, then you sort of become like the villain. Anything you say, it doesn't sound as funny anymore. I've said some things maybe, you know, after I said them, I thought, you know, I should probably taste my words before I spit them out there like that. But I've made a point, I never look back. I never look back, and that's the only way you can keep yourself going in this business. Don't look back.
In his first three attempts, Baffert took Louisville by storm. After setting that high standard, the last two derbies have been disappointing. Racing's Golden Boy was now outside the winner's circle that had defined his confident personality.
After you won the Derby a couple times, you're expected to do this every year. Now I'm feeling like it's all coming back together. Last year was sort of a rough year, but this year looks like things are really starting to pick up again.
That's Point Given, the leader. He's just putting on an exhibition run for us. Point Given, he hasn't taken a deep breath. Look at this guy go.
Watching Point Given come down the stretch, I thought, man, maybe this is the one. I got sort of goosebumps. This horse is showing me a dimension that I've never seen in any of the other great horses that I've trained. He's just so intimidating to other horses. He's so big. He's like a big locomotive. He knows now that he is the dude. He knows what he's supposed to do, and he's enjoying it.
Baffert is also enjoying this year, returning to Churchill Downs with a clear favorite. But there's a second weapon in his arsenal, the late developing Congaree, winner of last month's Wood Memorial.
point given running around the racetrack without a bridle on looked a little startling. That was true. He got loose at Santa Anita when he threw the exercise boy. He pulled the bridle off. He was loose on the racetrack with no bridle, and that is a really hard thing to capture. But he was perfectly all right, but Bob Baffert said it was enough to turn his white hair black.
Bob Baffert says the point given thinks that all that rearing up is cute. It doesn't make Bob Baffert feel too cute sometimes, though. He's been kind of laying low lately, hiding out on the backstretch. We'll see him shortly. One of the horses he's hoping to beat today is Millennium Wind, winner of the Bluegrass Stakes, who's had all sorts of physical problems, even threw a couple of shoes and had to be reshod here at Churchill Downs, but no damage done. He had enough problems to start with, and for more on that, let's check in with Mike Battaglia. Mike?
Well, you're right, Tom, and for 30 years, trainer David Hoffmans has been waiting for a Derby contender, a Derby starter. He's got one this year in Millennium Wind, but it was not easy getting this horse up to the race. Millennium Wind has been plagued by problems throughout his career, a skin rash that's been bothering him all of his life, and a problem with cracked heels. The cracked heels really surfaced again after Millennium Wind's romp in the Bluegrass. Now, Dr. Alex Hardhill, noted veterinarian, has developed a salve, and he's been treating Millennium Wind with this salve, and he has responded beautifully to the treatment. So David Hoffmans has been dreaming of this race for about 30 years. He has got Lafitte Pincai, the world's winningest rider, aboard. This is a half-brother to Charismatic, and I know Baffert has got both of the aces, but David Hoffman's had a dream. He dreamt that Millennium Wind was going to win this race with Lafitte Pincai aboard, and Millennium Wind could make that dream come true this afternoon.
All right, Mike, as we noted, Millennium Wind, a half-brother to Charismatic, in fact, was born in the same stall at Parrish Hill Farm in Kentucky, and he was a $1.2 million yearling. Bob, you have something from the backstretch there?
I just want to historically acknowledge the emotional reunion of Mike Battaglia and you, Tom Hammond, here at the Kentucky Derby. I believe it was the Citation Derby of 1949. You two last worked together.
We don't go back that far.
Well, we're going 3-5 on Spectacular Bid, 9-5 second choice Flying Pacer.
You thought I was sick before. That really made me feel sick. I thought we destroyed all that tape. Anyway, we have been at Churchill Downs a lot of time. Let's take a look at the current odds for the 127th running of the Derby. Song and a Prayer continues to be a long shot. Millennium Wind at 9. Balto Star, a 7-1 shot. Thunder Blitz, a lot of people like him, is a live long shot, 23-1. Congaree at 7. Dollar Bill continues to get support. He is the second choice at 5-1. Monarchos is at 10-1. And Point Given continues to reign as the favorite. He is at 2-1.
Over 90 evaluations in key areas like safety, performance, and comfort, and concluded Chrysler Town & Country is the best minivan ever. Drive one and see why Chrysler tested better than Ford, Toyota, Honda, or anyone else.
Tuesday, only 3 new Frasers left. They flirted with a possibility. Now,
you're jealous?
Frasier and Roz confess their feelings.
Why, not me?
I had a little crush on you.
And on the Three Sisters finale, Sisters at Odds, secrets revealed.
We're still married.
And one man left to cope with it all.
Oh my God!
All new NBC Tuesday. Turtle Wax. Grizzly Grill Guards. Rancho Shocks. Gas cans. Advance Auto Parts carries more parts than any other store, including one you won't find anywhere else.
We need some help. We need a lot of help.
Advance Auto Parts. The best part is our people.
In Buffalo, we get much of our drinking water from a lake and river with a history of pollution. So Two on Your Side reporter Mike Igo wanted to ask a question, a good question. How safe is your drinking water?
I have noticed in the fall or late summer, it does taste a little different.
It was such a good question. He asked it about filtered water and bottled water and brought them all in for testing. Was there any difference and is there any risk? We'll satisfy your thirst for knowledge in Testing the Waters, Wednesday at 11 on Channel 2 News.
Are you in the market for a mid-size sedan? GM's Giant, Jim Ball, Pontiac, GMC, Buick, and Resale has over 1,000 vehicles in stock now. Grand Prix, Grand Am, the Tiger Woods-endorsed Buick Regal, and this Buick Century, only $279 a month. Or get a $750 rebate plus 0% financing. Test drive any vehicle this month and receive a $20 gift certificate to Zeb's Restaurant.
Channel 2 News, Mike Letella on your side.
We're back at the Kentucky Derby, where Lafitte Pincai is in the jockey's room getting ready to ride Millennium Wind. And for many jockeys, including Lafitte, part of being a rider is battling to keep at riding weight. And for Lafitte, a new diet emphasizing fruit has turned his career around. He's now 54 years old, and he seems to be as good as ever. And the weight is under control for the first time since he was a teenager in Panama.
I started going to Detroit when I was 15 years old. I was discouraged by people that told me that I was going to be too big because I have big hands and big feet, so they figured that I was going to be very heavy. And I wanted to prove that they were wrong.
People outside of racing don't know that much about him. The discipline and dedication that he has, it's no telling how long he can go. I mean, I won my last Derby at age 54, and I was on my way out, and he seems to be going as strong or maybe stronger than he ever did right now.
Lafitte has set new standards for us as jockeys. He's 54 years old, and he's competing like a 20-year-old. He never misses a day. He's always the first one in the jockey's quarters in the morning, and he's usually the last one to leave. He's a polite man, he's a quiet man, and the ultimate professional.
Lafitte Pincai has ridden in 19 Kentucky Derbies, tasting victory only once, and that was 17 years ago.
By the 16th pole, I knew how the race won, and I'm telling you, I start feeling really good. And crossing the wire, I mean, that's the happiest I've ever been in my whole career.
He went through a slump, as we all do in this game, and it wasn't anything he was doing. It was he lost the better horses to ride.
Even the greatest can be mortal. And maybe it was time to bask in all his previous glory. Tired of fighting the weight and not getting good horses was virtually forcing him from the sport he had dominated. But he didn't give up.
I thought about retiring many times. I kept saying, well, maybe I'll give it another year, one more year. I didn't tell anybody, but I thought about it many times.
As Lafitte Pincai Jr. becomes the world's all-time winningest jockey.
It's a lot of up and downs in this game. Sometimes you have great days, and sometimes you have bad days. You have to learn to take the good with the bad, and time took care of it. And I learned, you know.
It's been 7 years since he's been back here. Now at 54, Lafitte Pincai is back in the Kentucky Derby.
I hope he feels like I felt when I won it, and I'm sure that he will. I will be rooting for him all the way.
And a look at the gap where the horses will soon be coming onto the racetrack. If you're interested in omens, Lafitte Pincai's Mount Millennium Wind here at Churchill Downs has been stabled in the same stall as Ferdinand, who was ridden to victory by Bill Shoemaker, 54 years old, in 1986. And, of course, Shoe is the man that Pincai passed to become the winningest jockey of all time. There's a live shot of A.P. Valentine, who is biding his time before making the ride over. And there's Gary Stevens, live shot from the jocks room. And Gary Stevens, the rider a point given, has come back from a brief retirement, which had been prompted by aching knees. But bad knees or not, Gary Stevens had to get back to riding.
Riding a horse, that's what I live for. spent 10 months in retirement, and I missed the sitting on a horse's back and trying to be one with the horse. To come back and have a clear mind, I think it's moved me up a notch.
Last year, nursing battered knees, he watched the Kentucky Derby from the grandstand. Just 6 months later, he was back where he belongs, in the saddle, riding in the Breeders' Cup, his first major test out of retirement.
When I put my helmet on for the first time in October of 2000, that was a new beginning for me.
A new beginning with a special horse.
I know he loves Churchill Downs, and he's a colt that is still learning. He's got a huge future ahead of him.
To ride Point Given, it's like my dream car, a red Ferrari that I have an unlimited gas supply. I can do with it what I want. You climb on his back, and immediately you get this feeling of confidence. He's very smooth. It's like you could set a glass of champagne on his back, and it's going to be, he's not going to spill a drop, whether he's walking or running. Everything just seems to be in sync with him.
And everything is in sync, too, for Stevens, who is back where he belongs.
Right now, I'm feeling good, and it's week by week. I don't know how long I'm going to ride. I hope to get another 5 years, but if I can get through the Derby and the Triple Crown, and it ends again, then my blessing's been answered.
And here's a look at the gap where the horses will soon be coming out. Meanwhile, if you've ever visited the Kentucky Derby Museum, as part of their presentation is this photo every year. It's the group photo of the jockeys just before the Derby. So just like your school photo, Gary Stevens and the others lining up for their official photograph before the 127th Kentucky Derby. Point Given still has not come out. They try to wait till the last minute because he's pretty playful. He likes to act up. This morning, he was rearing up for about 10 or 15 seconds, gave everybody some scary moments, but he was all right, and he'll be on the scene shortly.
Well, it's that time of year again, and you're stuck in the heat watching the mercury rise.
Want to make sure that doesn't happen to your summer? Get you and your friends entered to win really cool Miller Time trips like these in our Miller Lite Get the Goods Summertime Promotion. Pick up your Miller Lite Get the Goods entry card wherever you see this display. What are you looking at?
I like this one and that one, Daddy.
You have to pay the man for the rabbits now. Can I write a check?
I have to see some ID.
Okay.
Love is in the air. Everywhere I have to call us in.
Okay.
Just a minute.
Daddy.
I have to see a second ID.
Okay.
This doesn't look like you. Date of birth. I have to phone this in.
Next time, use the Visa check card instead of cash or checks. It'll get you in, out, and on with life.
Mother's maiden name.
This is a bucket of water. And this is Goodyear's new and improved AquaTread 3. At highway speeds in a downpour, a set of AquaTread 3 tires pumps away over 6 gallons of water per second. That's over 360 gallons per mile. With its 80,000-mile tread life limited warranty, that's a lot of water. Think about it next time it's pouring buckets. New AquaTread 3. Only from Goodyear.
Goodyear, Goodyear.
People are beginning to think of the automobile as a personal and individual means of transportation.
In order to continue moving forward, you need to remember where you've been.
Give them an expressway and they're...
Our future reflects our past. It's how we build great cars.
At the Chrysler Proving Ground,
the job of a powerful engine.
Expectations run high in this family. And now Chrysler PT Cruiser is Motor Trend's 2001 Car of the Year.
You really have to drive it.
You know you make me wanna take my hands off, shout, throw my hands out, shout, come on,
spotlight show of the week is The West Wing.
I'm going to tell you something shocking.
An amazing episode, even for TV's most honored show. Oh, and one more thing. Don't miss the last 5 minutes. All new West Wing, NBC Wednesday.
Back at the Kentucky Derby, live shot of Bob Baffert, and behind him, the massive Colt Point Given, who is the 2-1 favorite. They came down their own private gap onto the racetrack, sort of. It's a straight line from their barn, but they want to keep him away from trouble as much as possible because he is liable to act up. Now, most of the times he acts up in the morning, not so much on race day afternoon, but you can see Point Given surveying the scene now as he gets set to make that walk over from the backside to the paddock to be saddled for the Derby. This is one of the most exhilarating parts of the Kentucky Derby, that walk over from the backstretch. And a man who has experienced that many times is Wayne Lucas, of course, one of America's premier trainers. Wayne had 20 straight years that he had a horse in the Derby. He won 4 of them. His string broken this year. It was a record, but it's broken. No horse for 21. It has to be a different feeling to be sitting here next to me instead of saddling a horse.
Tom, I'd rather be walking over with the other guys. I really would. But it's a great day. Great day for a good race.
But you do have rooting interest. First of all, you have 2 of your former assistants, Todd Pletcher and Dallas Stewart, that have horses in the race.
I'm really pulling for them. I'm trying to be objective and handicapping, and I'm not a very good handicapper, but my heart really is with those two guys. I would love to see them be successful here. I think it's just a matter of time, Tom, till they do win one, but it would be nice if they could pull it off right away.
And you do, of course, train Thunder Blitz to win the Kentucky Derby. He has 2 sons running today, too.
Well, this is really prominent. And, you know, it's ironic that Point Given, who has, a little bit of a tendency to act up on the walk over, I think you could take Thunder Gulch and probably tie him to a tree behind the grandstand here and have gone and gotten him at 5:30 and he'd run well.
I said Thunder Blitz, Thunder Gulch, yeah. Obviously, in 1995. Well, right now, Donna Barton Brothers is with one of the former Lucas assistants. She's with Dallas Stewart. Donna?
I am here with Dallas. Dallas, you've made this walk over many times with Wayne Lucas's horses. This is your second time to make it on your own. How is it different?
Well, I tell you, this is a great walk. I mean, other than the birth of your kids and the joy of your family, this is just the thrill of what we love, you know. But I tell you, I feel like I got a nice horse today, and I think he's going to run great.
Well, you train here every morning. You look up at those twin spires every day. Do they look different right now?
I tell you, I've got a chill running from my heel up to the top of my head.
All right, good luck to you, Dallas. Back to you, Tom.
All right, Donna, as you see the horses making their way, number 10 is Dollar Bill, who has surprisingly been second choice in the wagering, opened at 10-1, and maybe because of the presence of Pat Day, Churchill Downs' all-time leading jockey, and one of the favorites here, he has been bet down at 5-1. And Mike Battaglia is making the walk over. He is next to John Ward, who is grown up in the shadow of Keeneland. He's the only Kentucky-born trainer in the Kentucky Derby, Mike.
That's right, Tom, and John is from a long line of trainers. His father, his grandfather, his uncle, Cheryl Ward, trained the great Forgo, and John, it's just got to be a special feeling walking over with the horse for the Kentucky Derby.
Oh, well, it's the greatest feeling in the world, and being a native Kentuckian, when they sing My Old Kentucky Home, there'll be a knot going my throat, and then this sudden dropping of emotion and said, could it be the year you can win one of these? And that's what it's all about in horse racing.
You took a little bit different approach than most of the other trainers. Everybody was out there working bullets. You haven't worked this horse since April the 27th.
Well, this horse has had a long campaign. He started with his maiden. He ran every month for the last 6 except for 1. So I treated him like a seasoned college a football team. I gave him a week off. Essentially didn't work him, didn't just put the 1 good scrimmage into him, and now, he should come back and be at his absolute top. If he isn't, then I'm a bad coach.
So he's got him ready, Tom.
All right, Monarchos currently at 10-1, but the favorite continues to be Point Given. He's at 2-1, and Bob Neumeyer's with his trainer, Bob Baffert.
With Bob Baffert and Point Given, Bob, a lot of pundits have touted your big horse as not only the winner of this year's Derby, but a legitimate Triple Crown contender. Is he worth the hype?
Well, I mean, he's showing the racetrack, but they keep forgetting about Congaree. We don't know how good he is. And this track, the way it is today, it might help. He probably have a little bit of advantage with the speed bias.
A couple of years ago, you entered 2 horses. Indian Charlie was your big favorite. You kind of surprised everybody with real quiet. I mean, is Congaree the same kind of scenario?
I think Congaree might be a little bit, I don't know if he's a better horse, but it looks like he can handle a mile and a quarter. But Point Given, I mean, he's done things that are, you know, pretty amazing, and he just gets better and better. He's a big, strong horse, and but they still have to get the trip. And I think today is the day we're going to find out if he's worthy of all that hype. And, I mean, the way he's been training, he just needs a trip, and we'll find out.
Let me ask you a hypothetical question. You have $100 left to your name in the world, and I said you have to bet it on either horse. Who would it be?
You know what? Everybody's asked me that question in a different way, and that's like asking me which child do I love more, so that's a tough one.
Tom Hammond, back to you.
All right, Bob. Well, if he's shopping for odds, Point Given is 2-1, and Congaree, last time we checked, was 7-1. In fact, here they are, 30-1 on Song and a Prayer, Millennium Wind at 9-1, Balto Star, trained by Todd Pletcher, the former Lucas protege. Congaree, 7-1, dollar bill's gone up to 6 now. Monarchos, the John Ward trainee, 10-1, and Point Given continues to reign as the 2-1 favorite. And the crowd of owners, in fact, a Congaree's owner, Bob McNair, made the walk with his horse. Owners, trainers, onlookers, and horses headed to the paddock for the Kentucky Derby. They'll be in the paddock when we return to Churchill Downs in Louisville. The 127th Kentucky Derby is brought to you by Visa, proud sponsor of the Visa Triple Crown.
Welcome to the Kentucky Derby, the first jewel of the Visa Triple Crown. Today you'll see the best that racing has to offer as horse and rider compete for their place in history and for Visa's $5 million bonus. Today we're proud to begin a new era of coverage for the Visa Triple Crown with our broadcast partners at NBC Sports. We wish all of the participants in today's race the best of luck. Thank you and enjoy the program.
An NBC motion picture event. A judge accused of murder.
You actually think he killed her?
The lawyer forced to defend him.
You owe me the truth.
I don't owe you anything.
A case you cannot predict.
She was hiding in the hall closet.
She might have seen something.
People Magazine's Show of the Week.
I sure hope he's innocent.
The Judge. NBC Sunday, 9, 8 Central.
Who makes the best minivan? Obviously, the press has already decided. Dodge Grand Caravan, the best minivan ever. See, compare, drive, Caravan.
Now with a $2,000 cash allowance or low 0.9 financing.
He sliced it into the woods.
I'll play it from here.
Should have packed a lunch.
Four.
What?
Look up, see blue. Labatt blue.
Hey, what can I say? I'm good in the woods.
I want to be an astronaut.
I want him to have a good doctor who knows his name.
I want to be the President of the United States.
I just want her to grow up strong and healthy.
Your child can grow up healthy with their very own doctor with Fidelis Care Child Health Plus. It's great health care for your child from doctors and hospitals you trust with coverage that costs you very little or nothing at all. Fidelis Care Child Health Plus is a part of New York State's Child Health Plus program. To enroll your child, call 1-888-FIDELIS.
WGRZ.com, your link to news and features that matter to you.
And the last of the Derby horses making their way along the track from the backstretch and into the paddock to be saddled for the Kentucky Derby. And there he was given up for dead by most, by all except a determined owner and a resourceful vet.
Everything was going completely smoothly. I mean, Invisible Ink was the star of the farm. He had a little nick on his ankle, and we gave him little antibiotics.
A routine small scratch had turned into an infection, which didn't respond favorably to the normal treatment.
The situation was a little more serious at that time than I was aware of. The horse had become depressed, He was in the early stages of extreme diarrhea or colitis. He'd lost maybe 200 pounds at that time. The horse was in such pain, you could see him go down, and each time he would go down in his stall, we thought, well, that's the last time. He's not going to have the strength to get back up. One of the veterinarians at the clinic said, you know, I don't think we can save this horse. She said, just go ahead and put him down. That didn't really suit me. I called Dr. Robert Copeland, and I said, Bob, you know, I think you can bring a horse back from the dead. This one's not dead yet, so it ought to be easy for you.
It was as drastic as anything I had ever heard, so I suggested that we do an old-fashioned treatment that I've done for years and years.
Bob's suggestion was find a farm as buttermilk, real non-pasteurized buttermilk. Put it out in the sun until it's got a crust on it and there dead flies all over it.
I don't know if somebody told me about this or if I just kind of figured out, but it just puts a new kind of bacteria to digest food and get the horse feeling a little better.
It was just buttermilk. I mean, it was the most incredible recovery of any animal that I have ever seen. His immune system began to restore. A month after that, we put him back into light exercise. Here we are running the Kentucky Derby.
It is an incredible story. Not only did he recover, not only did he recover and get back to the races, but here he is in the world's greatest, the Kentucky Derby. Invisible Ink, a long shot on the board at 50-1, which brings us to the subject of just who will win the Kentucky Derby. Let's see what our handicappers think. Let's check in with Bob and Mike.
Well, Tom, I think the first order of business, Mike, is to kind of define the race as to what horses will be in what position.
Right.
We think they fall into three rather evenly balanced groups.
Right. First, we've got the speed horses, and there's a lot of speed down along the inside in here with Song and a Prayer, with Millennium Win, and with Balto Star. Of these, I think Balto Star will probably get to the front, Congaree and Keats on the outside in a pressing position.
And now we have our stalkers, and this is the group that sits, so maybe between 6 and 10 lengths off the lead pack, and of course the obvious name is Point Given. We could have really put him in any one of the three categories, but he should be in prime striking position from the outside.
Point Given is so versatile that he can go to the front. He can come from dead last, but I would expect he would be a stalker in today's race. Gary Stevens has the 17 post. He can watch what's going on the inside and pick and choose his spot.
And then we have the closers. This style, Mike, plays particularly well here in the Kentucky Derby, and we have most of the horses are part of this category.
They really are, and we've got some that can fly at the end. I mean, take a look at these closers in here. Thunderblitz, 50 stars, AP Valentine, Dollar Bill, and Monarchos, probably the best two of the bunch. Monarchos with that huge run in the Florida Derby.
Well, we talked about the versatility of the favorite, and we give you two examples to show you about this wonderful horse, Point Given. The first is the Breeders' Cup Juvenile that was held here at Churchill Downs last year as a two-year-old, and this race illustrates his ability to come off the pace. He was beaten only in nose by Macho Uno.
Right, to come from far off the pace, as a matter of fact. Point Given right here is absolutely last at this point. And all of a sudden, you'll see him. There he is in the green and white silks with the green cap on the outside. He is going to come from dead last. Here he is now. He's made his move right there at the wire. He falls a nose short of Macho Uno, but he came from dead last. There's the photo. It was a nose. What an effort.
And that was the race he came from way downtown. But we have the Santa Anita Derby where there's a lone speed horse in the Crafty CT, but he jumps on him at the half-mile post, showing Mike he can also show that kind of lick as well.
Gary Stevens, such a crafty rider, knows that he can't let that horse loose on the front, so he uses Point Given early. Does it matter? No. He draws off to win by 5 lengths in the Santa Anita Derby, going 1 1/8.
Great pedigree, versatile style, experienced trainer, and a money rider. Add it all up, you get 2 votes for the favorite.
Who could ask for anything more? Point Given.
All right, guys, you like the favorites, unanimous, and the jockeys making their way from the jockeys' room into the paddock where they will get their final instructions from their trainers. There's the veteran Larry Melanson going by. And the jockeys will meet with the trainers, get final instructions. Gary Stevens slapping hands on his way to the paddock, and a reunion with Point Given. We'll be back.
Some athletes don't care about endorsements. Some athletes don't care how many fans they have or what kind of shoes they wear. Some athletes don't even care if they're televised coast to coast. They just want to run. The Visa Triple Crown takes a lot of heart, but at the ticket booth, they don't take American Express. Visa, the official card of the Visa Triple Crown.
Under a big sky, working in the field, on the brewery crew to the lager and man. Get it to you fast and fresh as they can. This is from the people working hard every day. Talking about the folks who get this bun my way. This bun's for you. And you and you and you. This bun's for you.
In our industry, we'll see 8 or 10 major manufacturers shrink to 4, 5, or 6 in the next 3 to 6 years. My job at Prudential is to help our investors sort out companies converting to digital, what we call e-business models. These companies are going to be the breakaway value creators. Even in a contracting economy, they can sled uphill. We can help our clients at Prudential profit from finding the winners as well as avoiding the losers.
Every day, new content gets created. But how can you get your hands on it? There's a place where ideas take shape and inspiration gets packaged. Where companies get the dynamic content they need to dramatically impact their websites. From information that moves markets to photos that rock the world every single day. It's iSyndicate, the content marketplace. Do you need to make an impact? iSyndicate, the I for content.
A shocker! The Miracle Mavericks pulled off a stunning comeback to knock off the Jazz. Their next challenge? Duncan, Robinson, and the top team in the West, the Spurs. The time is now. The place is here. The NBA playoffs on NBC. Coming up next, immediately after the Kentucky Derby.
Big crowd in the paddock and adjacent to the paddock as they survey the 17 horses that make up the field for the 127th Kentucky Derby from Churchill Downs in Louisville. And Point Given continues to rule as the 2-1 favorite. Let's update the odds. Millennium Wind at 9. Balto Star, the Speedball, he's at 8-1. Express Tour, 18-1. Congaree is at 7. And Dollar Bill at 6-1. Monarchos, a 10-1 shot. And Point Given is still the 2-1 favorite. And Dollar Bill at 6-1 has gotten, Chelsea, a lot of attention. Perhaps the fans think that this hard luck horse can bounce back. He was in trouble in the Louisiana Derby, nearly went to his knees, didn't like the track at Keeneland in the Bluegrass Stakes. Maybe he can get a clean trip today.
And also he gets a very sharp pace. He's a come-from-behind horse. That's why he got into the trouble in Louisiana. Then he came back and ran in the Bluegrass, and it was really kind of a speed-favoring track. He did close to finish third, but he had no chance on that kind of track. Pat Day, of course, is aboard, who has won more races than any jockey in history here at Churchill Downs. I think that plays a little part in the betting too, Tom.
Well, speaking of the betting, I don't know if Kentucky fans are betting on this one. Louisville fans are, however. This is AP Valentine, owned by Rick Pitino's old Memorial Stable and Michael Tabor. Rick Pitino recently taking the job as Louisville basketball coach. The Kentucky fans, some of them didn't like that much. AP Valentine had a tremendous race to win the Champagne as a 2-year-old, but really hasn't been able to duplicate that form for Nick Zito. Express Tour, representing the Mokhtoums, has had only one race in Dubai.
He won the United Arab Emirates Derby over there, which was a $2 million race. But he had a very good 2-year-old campaign down in Florida, and Sheikh Mohammed has quite a few horses there, his own racetrack, and I'll guarantee you this horse has been in a couple of mock races. Not that anything can sort of take the place of a good prep race for the Kentucky Derby, but I think he's coming here off a little more than the one race.
And some people think that Thunder Blitz, number 4, is a live long shot. He's really thrived here at Churchill Downs. He won the Flamingo by nearly 7 lengths in his last start.
He's coming out from the shadow of his stablemate, the two-year-old champion Macho Uno, who won the Breeders' Cup Juvenile here last year. Thunder Blitz is a May foal, so he was a little bit later to develop, and when Macho Uno went to the sidelines, Thunder Blitz picked up the slack, won the Flamingo Stakes, and has trained very nicely here. He's been catching a lot of eyes. He and Express Tour probably have had the most conversation about how well they've trained here at Churchill this week.
There are some of the primary contenders that we haven't seen yet that are making their way around the paddock. Right now, Mike Battaglia is in the paddock, and he's with John Fort. We saw the story of Invisible Ink, and John Fort is on hand to see his colt saddled for the Derby.
John Fort, we just saw the piece about Invisible Ink a year ago. Did you think this was even a remote possibility for this horse to run in the Kentucky Derby?
Mike, this horse is a profile in courage, and I tell you, if ever there were a poster boy for thoroughbred racing, it should be Invisible Ink. And I'll tell you, this is a difficult sport, and it's this horse that's given me the courage to persevere and, you know, compete. And here we both are at the highest level, and I tell you, I'm just overcome with emotion. This is the greatest day I've ever experienced in my life.
John Fort, thank you.
And let's go down to the paddock now, and Bob Neumeier, who has been keeping an eye on Congaree.
Tom, this is a remarkable story. It really began at day one for this horse. He was an unusually large foal, and the birth was a very difficult and dangerous one. He actually broke five ribs that was so close to his heart they could have easily punctured that organ. Eventually on an oxygen tank, survived that, then suffered a bout of pneumonia as a weanling. I mean, what else could have gone wrong? They tried to run him as a two-year-old. He got sick. They ran him later on. He chipped a knee. And so you can imagine that all the potential of Congaree, a son of Harazi, looked like it was going up in smoke. But then Baffert put him on the track in February, and whammo, the rest is magic. Three straight wins, including the Wood Memorial, a decisive victory over Monarchos. He is a threat, and Tom Hammond, of course, we remember Arazi as being that juvenile, the sire of this great colt, electrifying as a Breeders' Cup a juvenile winner here at Churchill Downs. He was a bust out in the Derby, but we remember Arazi very well.
We do remember Arazi, who had an NFL connection. Ralph Wilson, his breeder, owned the Buffalo Bills, and Bob McNair, the man who brought the NFL back to Houston. The Texans begin play next year. It cost him, counting their stadium, about $1 billion. Well, the post time approaches for the Kentucky Derby here, and we think back 60 years ago when Calumet Farms Whirlaway took the track for the Kentucky Derby. Whirlaway was in the Devil's Red and Blue and had been erratic. He'd been bearing out in races, so Ben Jones, his trainer, devised a special set of blinkers to try to make him go straight in the Derby, and Whirlaway is the subject of our Chrysler Triple Crown moment. The track was fast May 3rd, 1941, as two Derby legends, Arcaro and Jones, teamed up. A field of 11 left the gate. But at the finish, it was all Whirlaway. Mr. Longtail had not only run straight, he had won by 8 lengths, a margin that has never been surpassed, and in track record time. Whirlaway wore the roses on the way to the Triple Crown.
Sebrings. Sedan, convertible, and coupe. They beg to be driven.
We were 6 weeks from graduation, the five of us. Riding home from the concert in the car with no air. And it hit me. Stay on that train forever.
green, warm green. Let's go get some broccoli.
Choo-choo, like the moon goes to. Oh, yeah. Dressy, wessy.
Oopsie, whoopsie.
Such a big girl in a swingy wingy.
Oh, boo, boo, boo.
Huh?
Is Daddy Weddy home from worky jerky?
When you're in desperate need of a night out, you need Broadway.com and Visa.
How silver
wonderful use of iambic pentameter.
Wampeter. Visa, the preferred card of Broadway.com.
$1 billion. That's how much Oracle saved in 1 year using its own e-business software. How much will you save? Oracle. Software powers the internet.
17 horses that will contest the Kentucky Derby with a purse of over $1 million. Dan Bork, the paddock judge, giving the order for riders up. And you're looking at Todd Pletcher on the right with Balto Star as he gives Mark Guidry a leg up. There's Millennium Wind and Lafitte Pinkai. And getting a walking ride into the saddle is David Flores aboard Express Tour in the Godolphin colors of Sheikh Mohammed. And there's a look at 50 Stars, one of the long shots, trained by Steve Asmussen, whose brother Cash was champion jockey many times in France. Express Tour carrying the Godolphin hopes. Now that Street Cry is out of the race, Arctic Boy, one of the long shots, number 7. There's Bob Baffert awaiting the order to put Gary Stevens aboard the favorite Point Given, who's down to 9-5 now. Prince Ahmed Salman of the Thoroughbred Corporation, the owner of Point Given. You see Richard Mulhall in the sunglasses on the right there, the racing manager. And Point Given gingerly being led from the stall, and Gary Stevens getting the leg up. Gary Stevens rode the sire of Point Given, Thunder Gulch, to victory for Wayne Lucas in 1995. And the horses head for the racetrack, and that magical time when we all become Kentuckians, if just for a moment.
Kentucky Derby. At this time, please rise for the playing of My Old Kentucky Home, performed today by the University of Louisville Band. The band is directed by Dr. Fred Speck.
Kentucky Derby. Number one, Song and a Prayer. This is Bobby Hurley's horse. The former Duke and pro player paid $1 million for this horse, who won the Fountain of Youth but was second in the Bluegrass. Can he go a mile and a quarter? The two horses, Millennium Wind, the half-brother to Charismatic, sold for $1.2 million as a yearling. Lafitte Pinkai, 54 years, 4 months old, is the rider. He'd be the second oldest behind Shoemaker if he wins, just by months. The three horses, the speed horse, the gelding Balto Star, has won 4 of 5 this year by a combined total of 40 lengths. But there's been no wire-to-wire winner of the Derby since Winning Colors in 88. Number four is Thunder Blitz from the Stronach Stables, and Joe Arsino, a May foal, as Charles C. said, just waking up, but won the Flamingo by nearly 7 lengths under his jockey Edgar Prado. The five-horse 50 Stars, the long shot, he was a $70,000 yearling who won the Louisiana Derby when there was a lot of traffic problems behind him. Donnie Mesh, who has a twin brother, Lonnie, that is also a jockey, is in the saddle. The six-horse Express Tour from the Godolphins, they purchased him in the States as a two-year-old after he swept the Florida Stallion Stakes, but it's tough to win all for one prep race, and that in Dubai. He's trained well here, though. Seven Arctic Boy, a real long shot. He's eligible for non-winners of two lifetime. He finished last in the Arkansas Derby on a track he didn't like in his last start. Number eight is Congaree. If you're wondering about the name, it's named for a river that runs through the University of South Carolina campus in Columbia. In fact, the owner, Bob McNair, was president of the student body at South Carolina. He's won 3 in a row, including the Wood. Nine horse is Rick Pitino's AP Valentine. What about his name? Well, he's the son of AP Indy. He was born on Valentine's Day, February 14th. Still looking to duplicate that champagne performance. Corey Nakatani, 0 for 8 in the Derby. The 10 horse is Dollar Bill and Pat Day, and you can check him out on his own website, www.dollarbill.ws, where he calls his fans the Billsters, as Pat Day rides in his 18th consecutive Derby. The 11 horse Talk His Money was taken out of the post parade early by Jerry Bailey for good reason. He's tossed the rider 3 times in the post parade, so 12 is next. That's Star Tack in the colors of the late Alan Paulson, one of racing's greatest owners, son of theatrical bred for the grass, has had most of his success on that surface. The 13 is the aforementioned Invisible Ink, trained by Todd Pletcher, ridden by John Velasquez, and another son of Thunder Gulch, just like Point Given. Thunder Gulch, the Derby winner in 95 under Gary Stevens. 14 is Keats, a late entrant after winning the Coolmore Lexington Stakes at Keeneland. He had trouble in the Spiral Stakes, then benefited from trouble at the start for some others in the Coolmore, trained by the transplanted Irishman Niall O'Callaghan, ridden by Larry Melanson, who becomes the 9th jockey to compete in the Derby in 4 straight decades. The gray horse is number 15, Jamaican Rama, closer, 2nd in the Arkansas Derby, his last start, the only cowbred, but under Eddie Delahousie, who has won the Kentucky Derby on 2 occasions, Gatto del Sol and Sonny's Halo. Number 16 is Monarchos. Brilliant winner of the Florida Derby for John Ward, ridden by Jorge Chavez and owned by John Oxley, who is contributing 1% of the purse to the Grayson Jockey Club Foundation should Monarchos win today. Bred by former Chicago Tribune editor J.D. Squires. And there's the horse of the moment, Point Given. His owner, Prince Ahmed bin Salman, is a new daddy. He has his month-old Faisal back in Saudi Arabia, a member of the Saudi royal family. Though he went to college in the United States at California Irvine, by design, Bob Baffert has given him only 2 prep races as a 3-year-old, and he has won them both. And that's the field for the Kentucky Derby. The 127th Kentucky Derby is brought to you by Visa, proud sponsor of the Visa Triple Crown. By Budweiser, with a crisp, clean, refreshing taste you'll find in no other beer. And by Sun America, the retirement specialist.
The family has always put in the forefront to protect the quality and the standards set by Adolphus Busch.
The deep sense of pride that my grandfather taught me, that my father continues to teach me.
I think he would be very happy that the generations of his family have practiced what he taught us.
When was the last time you felt
284 horses tugging at your soul. When was the last time you immersed yourself in hand-tufted virgin leather? Can you really put a price on this kind of perfection?
Actually, you can. Because this $70,000 car could cost you over $326,000 in retirement savings. We just thought you should know. Ask a financial advisor about Sun America, the retirement specialist.
This is a bucket of water. And this is Goodyear's new and improved AquaTread 3. At highway speeds in a downpour, a set of AquaTread 3 tires pumps away over 6 gallons of water per second. That's over 360 gallons per mile. With its 80,000-mile tread life limited warranty, that's a lot of water. Think about it next time it's pouring buckets. New AquaTread 3.
Serious freedom.
Only from Goodyear.
Goodyear, Goodyear.
Over 17 years ago, the Chrysler minivan was born. A vehicle so revolutionary, it quickly became part of the American landscape. Today, the re-engineered and redesigned Chrysler Voyager continues to define the shape of family travel. Even with innovations like dual sliding doors and over 45 standard safety and security features, it's still the most affordable minivan you can buy. Now get a $2,000 cash allowance or 0.9% APR financing on Chrysler Voyager.
Some athletes don't care about endorsements. Some athletes don't care how many fans they have or what kind of shoes they wear. Some athletes don't even care if they're televised coast to coast. They just want to run. The Visa Triple Crown takes a lot of heart, but at the ticket booth, they don't take American Express. Visa, the official card of the Visa Triple Crown.
Costas back at the Derby. The home stretch here at Churchill Downs measures 1,234 and a half feet. This stretch, in the shadow of the Twin Spires, can often get the best of an otherwise outstanding thoroughbred. In just a few minutes, we'll find out which horse can best sustain the long, grueling drive to the wire and etch his name into racing history as the 127th winner of the Kentucky Derby.
Minutes to post time. Days of preparation. Years of wondering, will my dream come true? Millennium Wind, guided by a legend and the prayers of a trainer.
I had a dream that the Fee Pinkai rode Millennium Wind, won the Triple Crown, and then he retired.
Bob Baffert dreams in duplicate. Can the power of Point Given be harnessed? Are we about to see the dawning of a true Triple Crown hopeful? Or will Congaree, his stablemate, be Baffert's triumphant return to the Churchill winner's circle? A similar Derby dream rises from an oasis, where Sheikh Mohammed brings his hopes aboard Express Tour. One of 17 hopefuls trying to catch lightning in a bottle. Years of wondering, days of preparation, minutes to post time. The dream is now. The run for the roses is next.
As the horses approach the starting gate, let's recheck the odds. Song and a Prayer at 35, Millennium Wind 9, Baldo Star 8-1, 7-1 still on Congaree, Dollar Bill still at 6, 10-1 on Monarchos, and Point Given at 9-5. The others are long shots. The closer, Jamaican Rum, at 20-1. And there's a look at Point Given and Gary Stevens as they approach the starting gate. And a look at Dollar Bill, ridden by Pat Day, riding in his 18th consecutive Derby. That is a record. So they're starting to load into the gate for the Derby. Over a mile and a quarter, they all carry 126 pounds. Grade one race with $1,112,000. The total purse, $812,000 to the winner. And the first leg of the Visa Triple Crown. And to call the Kentucky Derby, Tom Durkin is high atop the stands here at Churchill Downs. Tom, what will you look for at the start of the Derby?
Well, at the start, I'm going to be looking at a few horses, particularly the first three from post positions 1, 2, and 3. Often in the Kentucky Derby, there's a lot of bumping coming out of those starting gates. Song and a Prayer, Millennium Wind, and Balto Star all have a lot of speed, so that'll be very key for them in the beginning. And then along with all of of the favorite players at Churchill Downs and around the country, around the world, in fact, to be looking at post position number 17 for the favorite Point Given. Keats goes into post position number 14. He's expected to deliver a lot of early speed, too. And there is Point Given. Point Given, a magnificent looking thoroughbred, standing 17 hands high. And he will stand in post position number 17 as he takes his place in the spot of the starting gate for the 127th running of the Kentucky Derby. The crowd starts to roar. We're ready for a start in the Run for the Roses. Talk as Money was acting up just a bit in the starting gate. And they're off in the Kentucky Derby. And Song and a Prayer comes out in stride from his inside post. Balto Star is there, not far behind Millennium Wind. And here comes Keats from the far outside. Bias for the first time. And it is Song and a Prayer to lead the way. Balto Star right there with him. Keats on the outside is running along in third. Millennium Wind in behind them fourth. Congaree is fifth. And Point Given is on the outside, heading for the clubhouse turn. He's racing in sixth position now. And then it's Talk Is Money, seventh in between horses. Express Tour is a close to the pace eighth. He's only about six lengths from the lead. Then it's a break of five lengths now. Invisible Ink is ninth on the outside. Star Tech is running in tenth. AP Valentine is 11th. Thunder Blitz lumbering along in 12th place. Then it's a break of another three. Back to Monarchos. Dollar Bill followed on the inside by Arctic Boy. A break of six to Stretch Running Long Shots. 50 Stars in Jamaican Rum. They're 20 lengths from the lead. The opening half mile was the fastest in Derby history. 44 4/5 seconds. Song and a Prayer's pace is blistering down the backstretch. With 4.5 furlongs remaining, it's Song and a Prayer, and he leads by 2 lengths over Balto Star. Millennium Wind is now third toward the inside. Congaree in good striking position on the outside. And the pent-up power of Point Given. 5 lengths from the lead, he's beginning to advance. Express Tour is right with him as the field rounds the far turn. Then Invisible Ink. Thunder Blitz is well within striking range. Jorge Chavez gets busy on Monarchos, and they're surging as they move toward the top of the stretch. And Congaree has come away with the lead. Here comes his stablemate, Point Given, on the outside. They're in three quarters in 109-1. Record time here in the Derby at the top of the stretch, and it is Congaree who is full out. Here comes Monarchos under a heavy drive on the far outside. Invisible Ink is there. Point Given, not today. 1 furlong left. Here comes Monarchos, who sweeps to the lead. He's pulling away by two. He's pulling away by three. Jorge Chavez and Monarchos have won the Kentucky Derby. And the final time was 1:59 4/5 seconds. He was as fast as Secretariat. And it was a photo for second there. Invisible Ink and Congaree as well. Absolutely thrilling. Jorge Chavez on top of the world. Jorge Chavez on top of the Kentucky Derby winner.
Celebrating a victory for the home team. John Ward, the only Kentucky-born trainer in the field. There's his wife, Donna, on the left, who is really co-trainer of all their horses. Jack Oxley, his wife, Debbie, who had come to the Kentucky Derby with Pyramid Peak and Jambalaya Jazz and not done too well a few years ago, decided to get into the three-year-old picture in a big way. They've been active at the sales, and here they are winning with Monarchos in spectacular time. Donna Brothers is on horseback next to Jorge Chavez and Monarchos. Donna?
Georgie, in your fourth attempt in the Kentucky Derby, you come away a winner on Monarchos. A lot of people lost faith in this horse after his Wood Memorial second-place finish to Congaree. How about you?
Well, I'm so happy. I'm excited. Oh, my God. And I have my first kid.
So you never lost faith in Monarchos' ability to win the Derby?
Well, I never did. I know he was ready for today. And always I was ready for him. I know that.
Did you have the kind of trip you'd hoped to get, Georgie?
Pardon me?
Did you have the kind of trip that you had hoped to get?
Nah, really. I don't want to move him too early because I know that the stretch is a little longer. I just wait, take my time, and I know when I move it, he was going to explode.
At what point did you feel pretty confident you could win it?
Well, the last 16th, but when I'm catching the horse stopping, I said, I got it. I just somewhat worried if somebody else was coming behind me.
Well, congratulations, Georgie. Tom, very jubilant. Georgie Chavez, winner of the 127th Kentucky Derby aboard Monarchos.
All right, Donna. And-
And John Ward has been telling anyone that would listen that the Wood Memorial didn't matter. It was just to get this horse ready. The second place finish behind Congaree didn't make any difference, that his horse was ready. He last worked him on Friday. He's the first horse since Bold Forbes in 1976 to win the Derby without a work over the track on Derby week. And Monarchos, with that late closing style, duplicating his massive move in the Florida Derby earlier to come home and take the Kentucky Derby. He came out of the Florida two-year-old sales for $170,000. He was the oldest horse in actual years in the race today, foaled on February 9th, 1998, the oldest of the 17. All horses have a universal January 1st birthday, but he was the actual in number of days oldest. And Jorge Chavez, who had been winless in three trips before today, gets under the wire in front. So now nine Florida Derby winners have taken the Kentucky Derby. Thunder Gulch in 95, the latest before today, as Monarchos, a son of Maria's Mon, comes home to win the Kentucky Derby. And Maria's Mon was a two-year-old champion, as we mentioned earlier. This colt is out of Regal Band by Dixieland Band and was bred in Kentucky by J.D. Squires, who was the former editor of the Chicago Tribune and now has retired to breed horses and make an occasional contribution to the Lexington Herald Leader. Monarchos, Invisible Ink. What a finish to that story. The horse that was near death a year ago, John Fort, was overcome by emotion in the paddock as they saddled his horse for the race. He had been behind Monarchos in the Florida Derby, and he gets second in the Kentucky Derby. Meanwhile, number 17, Point Given. The super horse predictions go by the boards, and Charlesy, I didn't really see any excuse for Point Given. He came out of the final turn in striking distance and just did not have the finishing kick. Here's Bob Neumeier.
Tom, I'm eavesdropping on a conversation between jockey John Velasquez and the stewards here at Churchill Downs.
Excuse me.
I don't want to interrupt the conversation, but what Velasquez is doing is claiming foul against Monarchos for alleged interference at the quarter pole. John, could you wait 1 second? Well, he's got the phone here. John, could you just explain to our audience you're claiming for?
Going right to the quarter pole, I mean, I'm making a move, and he moving the outside of me, kind of brought me in, put me behind the other horse, kind of had to steady a little bit my momentum. I had to take a shot and claim power against him.
So Chavez shut you off exactly where in the track
right
again?
By the quarter pole, past the quarter pole.
Do you think this is a means for a disqualification?
Well, I sure hope so anyway, but, you know, I'm going to try.
Right, John Velasquez taking a shot here on a DQ involving
Stevens,
the unofficial winner, Monarchos, and Invisible Ink, the unofficial second place finisher. Now it's up to the stewards.
All right, we'll take a look at it. There has never been a race disqualification in the Kentucky Derby.
All right, we'll take a look at this. We see in here we're looking for Invisible Ink, number 13.
Invisible Ink, like Monarchos, coming from off the pace.
Figure eight.
Number 13, you see him in the purple silks. Coming between horses here.
He is in the middle here. There's Invisible Ink.
Monarchos on his outside as Chavez hits Monarchos right-handed right there. And Monarchos coming in and brushing a bit and maybe cutting in front of Invisible Ink right there as Chavez switches to the left-hand whip, try to keep his colt straight. And here is Monarchos that will then go on and put some distance between himself and Invisible Ink, and that could play in the steward's decision. He did win by such a decisive margin, but he definitely did come over in front of Invisible Ink.
He did not appear to impede Invisible Ink's progress, though.
It didn't appear that Invisible Ink had to check stride at all as we looked at that replay. So the result not yet official, but Invisible Ink claiming foul against Monarchos. Meanwhile, somebody else that's not feeling so good right now, Gary Stevens on Point Given. He's with Mike.
Thanks, Tom. And Gary, you were laying right off of that very quick pace turning for home. You asked the horse to run about the quarter pole, and then what response did you get?
I didn't get much of a response. I got over to where I wanted to be, had good position going into the first turn, but he wasn't toe roping me like he normally does. And Like Bob said, sometimes they just don't show up, and he obviously didn't show up today. Right here, you can see, I'm urging him a little bit right here, hoping he'll grab a hold of me a little bit and give me that confidence that I've talked about, and I wasn't feeling it. He gave me a little glimmer of hope going into the last turn right here. I'm just behind Congaree. Got some, you know, the horses that I'm concerned about up front of me, and Bob told me, he said, don't let Monarchos get first run on you, so I'm positioned pretty much where I want to be here, but as you can see, I'm letting him bounce along, and he's not doing a whole lot for me, not giving me a lot of confidence right here.
Right, and you've ridden him so many times that you really know what kind of horse this is. Were you kind of shocked at this point?
Yeah, as you can see right here, we got David Flores on Express Tour running up inside of me, and I had to hold my position. I really had the ride to hold Flores in the position he was in on Express Tour, and I try and get my horse a little bit of a breather right here, and I just I didn't get the response after the breather I was looking for.
All right, thank you, Gary. Gary on the favorite, point given, just did not fire. Right behind me, Georgie Chavez is on the phone with the stewards, and we'll see if we can pick this up.
Really.
Stewards are looking at this right now. Georgie Chavez talking to the stewards right now.
I touch nobody. And the corporal, no, stop the stress. I don't think so. I go to the outside, and I was clear, boss.
Telling him he was clear at the top of the stretch. Georgie Chavez, the claim of foul is at the quarter pole, the top of the stretch, and you thought you were clear?
Yeah, I think so was clear. I don't think nobody was close to me. My horse was exploding, so my horse just, when I just let him go, he was just go, you know. I don't think so makes sense if I go out inside. I don't think so. I bother nobody.
Were you even aware that Velasquez was there with invisible ink?
I don't even see him. I don't know where he was. Only what I know, I have so much horse, and my horse was exploding. You know, he was going.
All right, they're calling for you now, Georgie. The claim of foul, invisible ink, against Georgie Velasquez on the winner, Monarchos, and it's in the hands of the stewards now, Tom.
All right, Mike, the running of the Derby has never seen the winner disqualified for the running of the race. The only disqualification, 1968, when Dancer's Image was found to have butazolidine, then illegal, in his system after the pre-race or post-race test, moving forward pass up to the win. So invisible ink, claiming foul. The stewards in their stands studying the visiting tape, and they have made their decision. The race is official. The race is official, and Monarchos is the official winner. There he is, number 16, Monarchos, who has completed the Derby in the second fastest time ever. Only Secretariat ran faster, the time 1:59.4. His brow after surviving the claim of foul. John Ward gives him a leg back up for the official photo. And Monarchos heading to the winner's circle. So a wave of the cap for Jorge Chavez, as Monarchos pays $23. Invisible Ink, $46.60. Congaree was third. Look at those exacta and trifecta payoffs. Back for the winner's circle in a moment.
When Hawaiian sumo legend Konishiki feels like Eurasian cuisine, he goes to Indigo. For Italian, it's off to Antipasto's, Makuau Steakhouse for steak, Cha-Cha-Cha Salseria for Mexican, Maguroya for great sushi, and who knows how many restaurants he'll eat at tomorrow night. But no matter where he eats, he'll be paying with his Visa card. Because like so many other great places in Hawaii, these restaurants don't take American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
Some experiences stay with you, like the feeling of driving the new Chrysler Sebring convertible. With a 200-horsepower V6 engine and race-inspired suspension, it's an exhilarating experience that lingers. qualified returning gold key lessees can lease the Sebring LX convertible for $329 a month.
Ask a financial advisor about Sun America, the retirement specialist.
The new version of Oracle will make your website three times faster, or we'll give you $1 million.
Churchill Downs Corporation, you've been around this great event for a long time. Monarchos just ran the second fastest derby in history, second only to Secretariat.
And I think that's terrific. And I think what's more terrific is the fact that he's a Kentucky bred. And before I introduce the governor, I want to welcome NBC Sports to the Kentucky Derby, more particularly to Kentucky. It's a delight having you here and telecasting our great event. And with that, let me turn it over to Governor Paul Patton, who will present the trophy to our winners.
Governor Patton.
Certainly seen a tremendous performance by a great athlete, Monarchos, that ran a great race. He's a great Kentucky bred horse, and we're proud of it. Congratulations to Mr. Chavez and to John Ward. Congratulations on a great training job. And it is my pleasure to present this most prestigious trophy in all horse racing to two great sports persons, preservers of this great sport of horse racing. Congratulations, and see you in the Preakness.
Excuse myself while I step in front of the governor here. John Oxley, you've been in horse racing for almost three decades. You were quoted as saying you thought that this moment would never come. And for a while, you weren't certain that it had because you had to wait out the objection.
Well, it's the fulfillment of a lifetime dream, perhaps several lifetimes, the most incredible experience of anyone's life. It's the greatest thing on the planet. And thanks to beautiful ride by Georgie Chavez, exceptional training by John Ward, we're just very thankful to be a part of the equation.
I know that you're something of a polo enthusiast. Has anything ever happened in polo to compare to this?
Well, I've won the U.S. Open, and I've managed to survive 40 years of playing on the field, but nothing comes close to this. Nothing in any life experience is like winning the Kentucky Derby here at Churchill Downs.
John, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
John Oxley, the owner of Monarchos. Let's go over to Charles C. Canty. Charles C.
Well, John Ward is making his way over here from the winner's circle. And I have to tell you, if anybody was ever confident this week, it has been John Ward. After the Wood Memorial, he said, that's okay, that's all right, we'll get them next time. It didn't faze you when they overlooked him all week long, John. You were fine. You said, we came here to run, and we will.
Well, that's right, and, I can only say that this is one of the greatest moments for me, and this kind of brings back some of the traditions of the people that I grew up under and some of the famous older trainers, and it's just the everyday discipline of take care of your horse, and he'll take care of you.
Certainly a dream for a third-generation horseman. Needless to say, you'll be taking the next step to Pimlico, I'm sure.
I have every reason to believe we will be there, and probably early like we did this time.
Hey, congratulations to you, to the Oxleys, and to your groom, Tammy Holtz. Lifetime dream come true for everybody. Back to John.
All right, for a recap.